So hi, so tell me, what inspired you to put on this event?
I noticed a lot of people talking about Brexit in the newspapers and on TV about, you know, us leaving the European Union, and a lot of people talking about, you know, immigration in this country. And also at the same time, the government have already gone back on their promise to keep the Windrush generation in the UK. And it really made me realise that people are not really considering the true impact of immigration and not seeing the benefit that it has to the country. And I wanted to do something with art, with culture, with music, that really showcased that there has been a powerful impact on the British experience because of the people that have come here. I wanted to showcase, you know, the impact of music or fashion, colourful art, films. You know, we've got some films that we're showcasing from Menelik Shabazz, and also documentaries that I've produced about black love in the UK. And all these things really do influence how powerful and also boost the British experience, so people can see that it's been a very positive impact. You know, it's important that people see that. And I think that BlackLifted does just that.
And what types of work do we expect to see portrayed here?
You can see some amazing work from Jonas Stout, who is a fantastic artist. He takes pieces of music and film and TV sets and turns it into unique pieces that you won't see anywhere else. We have Carnival Arts from Lynette and Carl Gabriel, who are fantastic exponents of wire bending. They are globally renowned. We have Mark Simpson from Black History Studies, who comes and talks about the message behind the music. So black anthems, carnival anthems, soca tunes, grime, hip hop, but the messages that are hidden that you perhaps didn't know about before, he talks about all of that. So there are some very, very exciting things happening within the season, and there's definitely a lot to be looking forward to. All these people would not have had an opportunity to showcase what they're capable of without having this space here. So it's fantastic for us as artists to have this space, and I think that Uthink are onto something here where they allow us to have the opportunity to do all this and to showcase this exhibition, because we wouldn't have had the chance otherwise.
So I really look forward to seeing, you know, what comes of this event
and
bigger and better in the future, and celebrating black art and culture.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So what's the inspiration behind your work?
It's a therapy process for me, yeah? I mean, I've been painting for many years, and then someone said to me, you know, you get to a point in your life where you kind of, you've got to do something for you. Do you know what I mean? An absolute gift, you know, arrived here that you think, which has just been fantastic for me. And you know, I've got this theory, if you put your foot down in a direction, the stepping stones will appear. And once I started doing this, then great, Viv appeared with the Uthink, and then we're all here having a fantastic time in this beautiful space, which is very lucky.
So why masks and shamans?
I just think they're, you know, kind of powerful. They really talk to you, don't they? The masks themselves are just incredible works of art in their own right.
Definitely, they're very vibrant, yeah. Vivid.
Yeah. This one, warrior woman. So I kind of felt that was that kind of an empowerment, female empowerment. This one's a shaman mask. They really tell a story. Because I paint passionately when I'm actually physically painting. I stand up and attack the canvas. It's a passionate process for me, if you like.
I like that, attack the canvas. No, yeah. Oh, that's great. Great opportunity.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, hope to see more from you in the future.
Thank you.
Take care. So tell me, what's the inspiration behind the event?
We've done a lot of event-based exhibitions here. You know, you might remember we did the Palestinian Carnival back in May and June. That was celebrating Palestinian culture. Just before I joined Uthink, I'd done a feminist art exhibition called Nasty Women. So it's good, and I think activism and art go together anyway, but it's a really good peg for getting themed exhibitions.
And tell me a bit more about Uthink, the charity. What's the aim?
The big aim for Uthink is to help artists by providing affordable studio space and affordable exhibitions and workshops, that kind of thing, because it's a really expensive thing for artists to have to do. They really struggle for space. I could take you along one floor up here at Hammersmith, and every single room on that floor is rented out to an artist. So they're here in the evenings, at weekends, painting. So it's a really valuable service. Earlier this year, we were very fortunate in being picked as an official venue for the Hammersmith Arts Festival, which was amazing. A lot of hard work, but really amazing. We had over 100 artists exhibiting here. We had over 1,200 people come to visit over the course of 10 days. It was really, really busy. And it was all sorts of things. We had traditional art, we had music, singing, dancing. So we'd love to do it again next year. So we've got to start planning for that, really.
And what's next for you, think?
Well, we carry on reaching out to artists and getting the very best of artists and the full range of artists.
So what type of works do we expect to see at this event?
Quite a big range. We've got a lot of artists in residence now. There's about 20, and some of those are putting work in, like Jonas Stout, whose work is behind me.
I don't paint like Picasso, but the shapes are similar to how he would do a brushstroke. So that's the similarity to some of my paintings than to Picasso's actual paintings himself.
And then Bespoke Diva, she makes greetings cards, really good illustrator, and she's done a Windrush collection. And not forgetting, because he'd kill me if I did, the founder of the charity is a guy called Gary Pate, who is a brilliant airbrush artist, whom he's doing some portraits on reclaimed pallet wood. So I've already ordered Jimi Hendrix, but there's lots of others to see too.
Amazing. So I'm just really excited to see what's next for you, think, and keeping up to date with all your future events and see what else is on the horizon. So cool. Brilliant.
Thank you.
Thank you.